Hello guys, and welcome to an episode of Patchwork. This is yet another indie game, and as usual, I don't know much about it. I'll put the link in the description, and it's free to play, so you can try it out for yourself. So let's just start. Load? Oh, okay. Start. Alright, let's see. Oh. All systems are operational. Processing input data. Please wait. Estimated time remaining, 15 minutes. 10 minutes. Oh, those minutes passed. 6 days? 40 seconds. Well, everything's going fine so far. The generator is on and fully charged. What else? Phone. Right, the phone! Use left click to interact with object, use right click to examine them. Okay, let's go and pick that up. Hello? Yes, I'm setting things up right now. Everything's pretty much ready, yeah. I'm good to go as soon as it's done processing the new data. Yes, I still want to test it myself. I built the damn thing. Come on, we've been through this already. No, I'd much prefer the first man to use my teleport to be me and not somebody else. Come on, it's been my dream since the first time I saw Star Trek. You don't want to crush my childhood dreams, do you? And this way, if something goes wrong, it'll be my own fault, right? No, no, I'm just kidding. I'm sure nothing will go wrong. All the animals were okay, weren't they? I'm an animal too. I'll be fine. Alright, I'll go check on how the computer is doing and start the thing up. Yeah, see you on the other side. Got a bottle of champagne ready. Get a bottle of champagne ready. Bye. Okay. Let's check the scanner. It's a 3D scanner. Let's examine it. This platform scans the object that needs teleporting and sends the data to the main processor. Okay. And this is the cupboard. Oh, no. This is the generator. It's working fine. A backup generator. It can supply everything in this room with electricity in case of emergency. Cool. Computer terminal. Please place the object due for teleportation on the scanner. The object due for teleportation? That's me! Okay. Nothing's happening. Something's not right. The scanner isn't working. If I open it, If I open it, I'll be in for quite a mess, so I'd rather not. Okay, it's fine. Bulletin board. Let's see, what am I supposed to do today? Oh, that's right, test the teleport I've been building for the last 4 years. Okay, don't need to get so, cheeky. It may not be a very good poster, but it's better than a blank wall. I'll leave it where it is. What about this, the device? My life's work, a teleportation device. I can't wait to try it out. Hopefully, I won't die. Okay, we can't do anything there. Hatch. I don't need anything from there right now. Okay. Oh, it's not plugged in. Connector. Ha! No wonder it's not working. There we go. It should be fine now. Okay, step on it. Well, here goes nothing. Scanning. Okay. Oh, this. I Are you sure? Okay, no turning back. I turned into a girl. Question 17. Name three herbs commonly used in the creation of healing potions. Let's see. Thyme, mandragora. What else? Oh god, I know this. Thyme, mandragora, and senna. Senna, of course. Fine, let's move on. Question 18. Oh, I can start doing stuff. Hello? Hello, Lynn. How are you, dear? Hello, Uncle. I'm fine. What's up? Are you studying hard for your exams? Of course, Uncle. Good girl. I'm sure you'll do great. Listen, I have a lot of things to do here, and I'm afraid I won't be able to come over for a few days. Come home. Yeah, that's fine. I read it. Oh no, I didn't. Nothing I can do. Don't worry about it, Uncle. I'll be fine. I'm a big girl. Yes, of course you are. All right, I should probably be going. Be good, Lynn. Don't do anything dangerous, okay? And don't forget to brush your teeth. I'll be checking up on you tomorrow. Okay, Uncle. Bye. So I have to study all to myself, huh? I'm not too worried about the theoretical part of the exam. I'm the best in class, after all. The practical application bothers me, though. We're going to have to summon and banish a small demon. Oh! This escalated quickly. I think I should try it right now. I mean, it's a perfect opportunity. It'll be like a rehearsal, only, you know, with demons. I know we're only supposed to do things like that under a teacher's supervision. But how bad can it be? I'm sure it'll be fine if I just follow the instructions carefully. Okay, I need to find the book of summonings. I don't think you should be doing this, Lynn. There's a reason why the teacher should be there, because they... Okay. Bookshelf. Okay, what have we here? History of Magical Arts, Theoretical Magic, Might and Magic, Magic Carpets, Incantations for Dummies... Aha! Here we are, the Book of Summonings. Let's see, demons... There we are, to summon a lesser demon, draw a pentagram on your circle, check. Then pour some basilisk blood over the circle and say, Kavye Aris Halila, forwards and then backwards. Okay, sounds pretty easy. And I think we had some basilisk blood around here somewhere. This is not gonna end well. Ingredients. No basilisk blood on this shelf, though. Maybe here? There it is. Oh, so now I have... Oh, I should save. I didn't know. Save this game as... save? save. Yes. Okay, I need the blood there. Okay, let's pour a little bit of this. There, done. And then we say the Halila stuff. Kavya Aris Halila. Okay, say it. Okay. A proper incantation circle is an indispensable tool for a young wizard. Yes. Kaira, yes, this one. Kavye Aris Halila. And then Halila Sira. I think this one. Halia Sira something. I think that was right. Oh no. Is it the professor? Yes! It's a tear in the fabric of time. What the? Kalia Sirs Clavde Horathia? Ichi Lemser Kefir Dinan? I don't know what. Kimarata Puzula? Can you understand me now? Yes, how did you do that? Magic, it's a pretty simple telepathy spell, really. But who are you? And what did you do to my house? You're not the demon I was trying to summon, are you? You look like the pictures. What? You're green. This isn't happening. It's not real. What? I don't know. I'm dreaming or I'm in a coma or... And this is my subconscious and you're my feminine side or something like that. Or I've died and this is purgatory. Or some other silly explanation straight out of the Twilight Zone. But it's definitely not reality. It can't be. Of course it is reality. What makes you think it's not? Well, magic is the obvious one. Also green humanoids with pointy ears, those don't exist either. But I'm right in front of you. Yep, that's why I'm saying it's not real. But my house and all my books, are you just going to stand there and wait until everything somehow goes back to normal? Yes, maybe. I don't know, it doesn't make any sense. You're probably right, there's no point in just sitting around, real or not. But what can I do? I mean, there's no electricity in this magical kingdom, is there? What's electricity? Exactly. Electricity is like this flowing current of electrically charged particles that... Oh well, you know, it's like lightning. Lightning? We can summon a lightning demon. Again with the demons, can't you just summon rain? I guess we can do that. Really? Well, I have to read up on it. But I think so, yes. This might actually work. It'll be like Back to the Future, only with the cars, without the cars or time travel. Right, in that case, we need to build a lightning rod to catch the lightning strike, summon the thunderstorm. Oh, we won't be able to contain the energy from the strike for long, though, so it's better if I find a way to power up the computer first. Okay, the computer first, then. Alright, let's do it. You figure out how to bring up about a thunderstorm, and I'll make some preparations on my own. I'm Daniel, by the way. I'm Lynn. Nice to meet you. Okay. Now you can switch between the characters by clicking on their icons in the left corner on the drop-down menu. Let's save again. Oh, save. Yes, save. Yeah. Okay, so we switch here. So this is now her, and now I'm him. Oh, I got some glasses. And I got a phone. How can I, okay. We need to fix the... I should try and power up the generator if I want to turn on the terminal. Yeah, so we have to do this first. Runs on fuel, but it's empty right now. Okay. It runs on fuel. What is this? Oh, nothing. I'm a mathematician, not a math. I didn't get it. It's a magic circle for summoning demons, ghosts, storms, and stray scientists, apparently. Maybe you should be her then. So she needs to summon a thunderstorm. The Book of Summonings, a short guide to basic and moderate summonings. Compiled by the Wizard Council of Temirtau. Third edition, Thurminar 528. Thunderstorm. We will need incantation circle. I think we have that. Water element. Okay. Fire element. Wind essence, harmony, and rain stick. While not very dangerous, rain summonings is not a simple spell. Rain summoning is not a simple spell. You'll need to have something from each of the four elements, which usually means dealing with spirits. See tips at the end of the book. Okay, so we need to do a lot of stuff before we... So I guess that's like the ending. Actually doing this is the ending of the game. Firstly, you'll need to draw the rain incantation. And on... Oh, this is the illustration. Okay. On your circle. After that, start introducing the elements in order listed on the previous page, okay? Elements can be acquired from their respective spirits. Wind essence is a part of a wind creature. Rain sticks should be made out of magic wood. And remember, all incantations should be drawn in one continuous line without lifting your hand. See our companion book, Incantations for Dummies. Okay, so we need to do all of this before we can actually... Okay, exit. But I think Daniel wants to start up the generator first. Can he use the telescope? It's a telescope with some pretty nice lenses. No. Window. Very gaudy-esque. This door doesn't seem to have any handles or locks. Strange. We cannot go outside. It doesn't open and there aren't any locks or handles on it. Oh yeah, sorry about that. Door, open, please. Oh, we can go outside. This is much bigger than I thought it would be. Fruit merchant. Oh, he walks very weirdly. Hello, sir, blah, blah, blah. May I say what a fine white garment you're wearing? Thanks. It's nice to see a person of class in our humble little village. You're not from around here, I take it. I guess you can say that, yeah. Ah, yes, thought so. In that case, I might interest you to know that I sell the freshest, most delicious fruit around here. Sorry, I'm not really interested in fruit right now. Nonsense! Everyone likes fruit, from kids to adults, from Crocman to Silurus. Here, try one, I bet. You'll be back for more in no time. Oh, okay, thank you. This fruit feels strange. It tingles my hand slightly. Powerful flavor, nothing to worry about. I really don't think I should eat it. I think it's pure acid. Also, this merchant seems fishy. Yeah, he's got his little comrade there. So now we got a fruit. Goldfish. I used to have a goldfish once. I'd rather not relive the experience. Okay. Was it that horrible for you then? There's a goldfish swimming in the bowl. Fruit. They look like a cross between apples and oranges. And it looks like they're slowly dissolving the crate that they're in. Yeah, I don't think you should eat that. Okay, so save it. Yeah. Okay, guys, I'm gonna end the episode here, and I'll be back with more Patchwork soon.